Hey guys, and welcome back for another video. Today I'd like to get started on the last collection required to unlock your Skyscale mount, and that's going to be Riding Skyscales. Before we get started, do make sure you head back to Sun's Refuge and speak with Gorik, who will update your collection and allow you to purchase the necessary items. The first part of Riding Skyscales is acquiring the Skyscale saddle, and this will require at least 250 of all the Living World Season 4 currencies. Outside of those currencies, you'll also need to generic Path of Fire currency known as trade contracts that you can get for doing basically anything in the Crystal Desert, and each item will cost you an additional 5 gold and 250 volatile magic. So with that in mind, head to each and every one of the volatile magic vendors in the Living World Season 4, and you should notice a new item has become available for 250 of that currency, 5 gold, and 250 volatile magic. To spend your 500 trade contracts, another 5 gold, and another 250 volatile magic, you'll need to track down Priory Historian Elisa. And I say track down because this NPC tends to move and isn't right next to a waypoint like a lot of these other vendors. To find this NPC, just click the link in the description, as all of those locations have been cataloged on the wiki, and it'll tell you where her current location is. And once you've purchased all those items, you're basically ready to do the very last part of this collection, but we'll be going over that in another video. For the rest of this video, I'd at least like to help you get some of the easiest currency that you can get in each one of these maps. For starters, if you didn't already know, if you head to Dragonfall at the Volatile Magic Vendor, you can spend a little bit of Volatile Magic to buy 5 of each of the currencies every day. The exception here being Mistborn Motes or the currency that you get in Dragonfall, and you can still buy 5 of these, but you will need to spend a fair amount of karma every day to get them. If you start to head down the path to the west, heading out of this area, you will see a Quartermaster or another Volatile Magic Vendor, and it's only at this vendor that you can buy more of the Mistborn Motes. For the rest of the Living World Season 4 currencies, you'll be going about it the same way on each one of these maps. Firstly, every one of these maps has some nodes that you can gather like any other gathering node. By completing some of the daily repeatable hearts, you can return to those heart vendors and purchase for some karma another 5 of each of the currencies, and you can get a few more by completing some meta events. It should be said that a lot of these meta events will only award currency once per day, and they do take a fair amount of time to complete, so I don't really recommend this as your best method. Instead, I feel like the best way to go about this is just completing daily repeatable hearts, and specifically the ones that are really, really easy to complete. Not just that, but if you have level 80 characters, you can port them to each one of these maps and continue completing the heart over and over again once per character for another 5 currency every day. Once you've exhausted the hearts, it'll be up to you to gather some nodes and perhaps complete one of the meta events each and every day for some additional currency. For the first map, or the Domain of Istan, head to the Astralarium waypoint, and all around this waypoint there are mirrors and obelisks that you can interact with in order to get some heart progression. And once you run out, you can head to the very base of the Astralarium where you can straighten some telescopes as well as record some star recordings to finish off the heart. In our second map, or the Sandswept Isles, head to the Anagile encampment waypoint, and you'll just be headed directly south of that waypoint towards a ton of inquests. You'll want to be taking out the inquests, their turrets, as well as inquest crates, and you can get some additional progression by collecting any of the golem core crystals and interacting with the scanners or the inactive golems. Using the crystal on the inactive golems will spawn a bunch of inquests, which will help progress this a little bit faster, so I'd recommend going that route if you see one nearby. For the third map, head to the Domain of Korna at the Epismic Grounds waypoint. Around the waypoint, you'll see a few markers you can interact with for a little bit of progression, and if you head south of the waypoint towards the swamp area, you could take out some fireflies. Now, taking out the fireflies doesn't actually get you any heart progression, but they do drop a special item. This item, or firefly bits, can be taken to any of the deposit areas surrounding the heart itself, and you'll get about 3% for each piece, but you do get several pieces for each firefly. If you're lucky, you'll also get an event to spawn, and it's just a defense event against some Choya, and by taking out the Choya and completing the event, you'll get a decent amount of heart progression as well. For the fourth map, or the Jahai Bluffs, head to Soul's Vendetta waypoint, and right next to the waypoint, you should see some training dummies and some branded crystals in front of them. All you have to do is pick up the branded crystal and throw it at the dummy, and if you do it just right, you'll actually hit all three of the dummies at the same time, giving you some bonus progression. The branded crystals continuously respawn, so just stand here throwing crystals until you complete the heart. For the fifth map, or Thunderhead Peaks, head to the heart of the Forge waypoint, and from this area, you'll just want to make your way to the west until you reach the next area. Here, you'll see several groups of people, as well as individuals with frowny faces above their heads, and to get started, you'll just want to head to the individuals rather than the groups, and once you're in front of them, you can just use your special action hotkey to sort of cheer them up. Each time you do this to an individual NPC, part of the bar above your own head will start to fill up green, and once it's completely full, you can start heading to the larger groups of people and doing the same thing. Since you interact with these NPCs by using your special action hotkey, you can actually do this whole heart while on your mount. For the sixth and final map and currency, just head to Dragonfall, and unfortunately there aren't any hearts on here that you can easily spam in order to get some easy currency, but also fortunately because instead of doing something boring, you get to play the meta event. Rather than just heading to Dragonfall and hoping for the best, I would recommend using the Looking for Group tool to find yourself a dedicated group for this event. Not only will the commander help you better understand this event and guide you through each part of it, but there are some time-sensitive parts of this that you'll want to complete as quickly as possible. The meta event is made up of several smaller events that upon completion will get you some Mistborn keys, and we'll be using those keys to open up Mistborn chests whenever you see them. At different stages of the meta event, completing some of the smaller events will result in some Mistborn chests that you can open up for some Mistborn motes, and at the very end of the main part of this meta event, you'll be able to open up several chests all at once. Be sure to hang around in that area as the commander will likely participate in a series of bonus bosses that take place after the main event. Taking down each one of these bosses is going to get you another 3 Mistborn chests, and as long as you have the keys to open them, you might as well hang around and get some extra Mistborn motes. In total, I think I had to clear this about 3 or 4 times before I had the 250 necessary, but I did start with about 50, so it might take a little bit longer depending on what you're starting with. Now obviously, you can complete all the hearts on all of these maps once per day on every one of your level 80 characters for some additional currency, as well as harvest any of the nodes on all of those maps. Any way you go about tracking down and collecting all of these currencies, I'd make it a daily activity, but not one that takes up all of your playtime, or you could get burnout before you get all the items necessary. But that, guys, is pretty much all I wanted to talk about here in this video. Just make sure once you have the necessary currencies, you track down each one of the volatile magic vendors and purchase the items required for the saddle. After this, we just have one more video, and then we'll finally be done with the Skyscale collection, and we'll have a new mount for ourselves to play around with. But anyway, guys, as always, thank you so much for watching any one of these videos. I hope you found this helpful, and I'll see you in the next one.